Nobody understands what it means to have autism and be a rapper with a dream, using lyrical metaphors to induce my self-esteem. Go ahead and cut off the lights for me to explain my mental hiccups, kind of bites. So I'm using these words that I write to talk about my past addiction, how it's hard to be reliving my plight. For years I didn't fight, cause I wanted to sweep my condition under the rug and live my life. And to be honest, we all paid a price. I paid mine cause I wasn't using what God gave me as a device. Yes, I turned myself over to Christ, but the community I was born in was still suffering at night. So when I decided to become an activist, I had to take my right palm and realize the shoulders that I was standing on and close my fist. So my journey just begun. I know it's gonna be a little rough, cause I gotta spread awareness for more than just a month. This is my story, my way. My grandma paid it for me. Lord, forgive me for not making this mandatory. So as I'm looking back, I can honestly say that I wasn't ready, cause they're deeper than accolades and confetti. I'm trying to save 70 million from the Serengeti. And autism is not just my life, it's my purpose. So I'm a voice for the unspoken and those who feel a little nervous. Cause when you look at me from the surface, it's hard to tell that 13 years I was worthless. And I'm just speaking openly and thanking God that He's chosen me for this type of degree. It's not all about me. For years I was Superman that carried a kryptonite gold team. And I just want to get justice for my league. I'm a soldier with gifts that equal 23. Hi, I'm Ernest Baskin and I fight for PTSD. When I'm really trying to get you to see that I'm no different with autism, I carry a college degree. And as long as I got God in front of me, I can do anything if I just believe.
Hello everyone, my name is autism activist Marcus Boyd. I was born with autism in 83, and I didn't get physically diagnosed until April 12, 1993. I was 10 years old. Like, they said I would need a permanent caregiver all my life. I would need somebody to help cook for me, wash my clothes, put on my shoes, all that wonderful stuff. I would never be able to function as far as educational. I would be in special ed all my life. I would need IEPs all my life because of the severity of half of my brain not functioning in the correct aspect. But, you know, that's why there's a God, because I am 36. I have a college degree. I have a bachelor's in journalism and mass communications. I cook my own food, and I put on my own stuff. And, you know, I've been on my own since I was 17. So I think that's why I really became an advocate, because I really wanted to help spread the awareness of autism and help share my story and show people that if God can do it for me, He can do it for you.